And how's the dragon not have any one drops? I'm gonna keep this hand. Hopefully, just draw a one drop, and then we play it. And we can play a turn two Yawgmoth Elder, which would make me very happy, but it was not meant to be. This hand's not exceptional, but I don't think you can mulligan this hand. There goes probably our Tidings, is my guess. Probably Yawgmoth Elder, actually. If he takes Tidings, we just play Elder, sack it, get a Plains, oust the Fiend, and cast Tidings. This is a pretty irrelevant Mesmeric Fiend. Our hand doesn't really rely on any of the cards in it. He took Sakashima's student. Interesting, okay. And we drew Plains. Here I definitely will pop this in my upkeep. Mind Stone. You lucky devil. You and your artifact mana. Wait, is it like Mana Leak here? Oh, or Manned? Okay, sure. What's it gonna be, sir? Thieving Magpie. Okay, we're gonna have to oust that thing, I think. I don't wanna let him draw cards. We could let him draw one to get this Elves into play. But I don't think that the acceleration is important enough in this spot. I think I'd rather just do this. So he's gonna draw the Magpie next turn. Okay, well, Poppy Mindstone is a good sign. I guess he's just gonna replay the thing. Yeah, okay, that's fine. I will certainly block. That was a bizarre attack. Maybe didn't realize that my guy still got to give me the lands. People, I don't know what just happened there. I'm just gonna copy his thing and play my elf here. It's possibly just gonna like Rouse Eric me, and I should just leave up Condemn. But I think getting the elf into play is more valuable. I need to empty my hand out so I can cast his Tidings, and I want to have mana left over when I do. So playing out the elf seems pretty. Pretty superior to leaving up a condemn that I probably won't even get to play. Yeah, so here, yep, so he just ships on the turn back. So he's probably holding like a dismiss or something, which means he's going to counter my Tidings, which would make me very, very sad. So I'm actually just going to pass the turn back to him. I mean, I have a million land in my hand. He does not, since he already just missed a land drop. So I'm fine just like playing lands every turn out. Necromancy. Why are you... What is happening here? He's end of combat necromancying... Oh, he wants to get lands? Oh, that's kind of clever. But why end of combat, not end of turn? Now I'm just going to play my Tidings second main phase now. I don't know why I did this end of combat. That was a pretty sweet necromancy though, actually. I do want to bring back in my my other thing. I didn't realize Necromancer could target my creatures. That's why I was so confused. I couldn't understand why he was reanimating them as Merry Fiend. And then... Okay, and then cast Tidings. Have I played my land? I have. So I'm going to leave out my green mana again, because green is the most likely thing I'm going to draw that I want to cast, which I do. Didn't draw a lot of action there. Really need to draw a Planeswalker. That is how we're going to win this game. Alright, what's he casting here? Liliana. Okay. Well, it's going to minus it almost certainly. I'm probably going to cast Armageddon here now since he's tutoring. I have tons of mana still available. Oh, bird ninjas. Kind of a cool creature type. What is he going to tutor for? So we know he has one land in hand, probably does not have a second, but certainly does not have the third. So we get to cast Geddon and then just go forest, cast Pride Mage. Which is pretty good. Now we can repeal his Magpie. And just kill as a Liliana? Is that better than casting Armageddon? Interesting. No, I'm reasonably concerned with whatever the heck he just tutored for, so. Let's tap all of our mana. No reason not to float it. Boom. Oh wait, we can still just bounce Magpie here, can't we? Yeah, oh sick, we still get to bounce the Magpie. I think bouncing Magpie is actually better than playing Pride Mage, right? Yeah, definitely. And then I'm gonna hit the Lily, I think. No, I'm gonna draw a card. I'll let him tutor again. Cards are sweet. Yeah, now he's almost certainly shooting for a land. At this point. And now I'm going to kill Liliana, draw a card, play a Pride Mage, I think. Is how this turn's going to go. Is that right? Play Pride Mage? Yeah, that's right. I should have held the land, I guess, until I drew my card off my Magpie, but I'm almost certainly playing that island. In fact, I am just definitely playing that island. Ooh, Fertile Ground. Okay, I was wrong to play the island. Now I can't play Fertile Ground and Pride Mage. So I just look silly. I drew, like, the one card that punished me for playing my land. So now I can either play Pride Mage or I can just get more mana. I just want more mana at this point, so I'm just going to Fertile Ground up my island. And feel silly that I can't now tap to cast Pride Mage. This gives me 6 mana next turn. Just hit with the Magpie. I could attack with these, but I really want to leave them open in case I draw something sick. I always have ways to spend my mana. Ways like this. And now I have, what is this, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to have 8 mana next turn, so I can cast this, so I don't need to play the Noble Hierarch, I can just cast the other guy. Hope I don't get Pyroclasmed. Oh, that's actually, it doesn't even matter. You Pyroclasm me, I draw a card off this, I still have my Magpie, I still have a bunch of mana. And now I'm just going to eat his Worn Power Stone with my Pride Mage, and then blow up this land with my Primus, I think. Or am I 1 mana short now? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm 1 mana short for doing that, okay. Guess I'm just attacking with these guys. Ooh, I drew Venser. Now I think I'm just going to Venser the Power Stone and play an Elf. I guess I just leave Venser up. Yeah, I'm just going to leave Venser up. That's even better. Do this. Do this. Do this. Has to turn back. Probably should be like killing him and attacking more things, but I think this basically plays around everything. Next turn I'll have 11 mana. Hello, Ralzerk. You're gonna have to take a little detour back to my opponent's hand, please. I can even let that thing resolve, probably, but. Ooh, people. So I have 10 mana. Upheal might be a win more at this point, but I kind of like winning more. 5, 6, 7. I can attack for 8. Or I can attack for 5. Upheaval, replay all my elves. That seems safer. Forest, cast Fertile Ground on it. Okay. Yep. Yeah, Upheaval, good card. Good magic card. Alright, back round 2.